Welcome back to Batman Arkham Knight. Picking up right where we left off, we are now in Ace Chemicals, searching for the missing workers, but no sooner did we find this guy than we were ambushed by the Arkham Knight himself.
The one giving the orders. He talked like he knew you.
That's very perceptive.
You're safe now.
You don't know the half of it, Batman. Scarecrow, he was...
Stay calm and tell me what you know.
They've been running the plant for hours. They brought in trucks, weapons, soldiers, shipments of hazardous materials. They knew exactly what they were doing.
He's producing his toxin on a massive scale.
It's a bad. Real bad. We're talking about a gas cloud that could cover the entire eastern seaboard.
Where do I find Scarecrow?
I got no idea. All I know is he's moving ahead with his plan. And he's got a whole freaking army backing him up. We're screwed, Batman.
I'll stop him. But first I'm getting you out of here. Wait by the Batmobile.
Now let's call up Jim Gordon on the Bat FaceTime.
Have you found Scarecrow?
Not yet. It's worse than I thought.
How much worse can it be?
He's building a bomb big enough to cover the entire East Coast in fear toxin. Take your men and get out of here. Head to GCPD and lock it down. Keep everyone inside.
I'll get my men off the streets, but I'm going nowhere. You bring anyone you find to me.
Jim, it's too dangerous.
You'll stop him. I know you will.
Hold tight. I'll get you to Commissioner Gordon.
Eventually. But first, I'm going to search the rest of the facility.
Master Bruce, there are militia tanks all over the city. Gotham is overrun.
If I don't stop Scarecrow's bomb, there'll be no city to save.
So skipping to the loading dock where the next worker is located.
When he comes up here, he's going to pick us off one by one just like the others.
I'm not scared. Let him come. He thinks he's the big man. He's not. He's on the extinction list.
So starting this combat off with a fear multi takedown. That guy in white was a medic, and if he were conscious, he'd have the ability to revive some of his fallen allies, getting no end of trouble. Lifting up this lead pipe just to throw some variety in there. And this guy is vulnerable to an environment takedown, in this case, this electrical panel on the wall. And then finish it off with a good old Shawn Michaels sweet chin music. I'm referencing professional wrestlers because some of the moves in Batman's repertoire sneakily resemble some finishing moves from the WWE. Now I'm being prompted to use the explosive gel to break through this structural weakness. This quasi-solid explosive is the first gadget upgrade you earn in Arkham Asylum. And look at how he sprays it in the shape of a bat symbol. Classic. And as we head behind this hastily repaired wall, we come upon the third Ace Chemicals worker.
That's two dead workers now. I should have stopped this.
Batman, look, I've been talking with Robin. I really think you should consider letting him help you. You're up against an entire army.
She's right. We're a team. This city needs both of us.
I can handle it, Robin. I've told you what you have to do. Now do it.
This can wait.
No, it can't. You know what's at stake. I need you to stay focused, or things will get worse. Much worse.
Now, Robin might know what's at stake, but we don't at this point.
That gas is toxic. I need to shut it down.
We can probably use the Batmobile to do that.
You shouldn't be so hard on Tim. He only wants to help.
Don't let your feelings for him cloud your judgment.
What a workplace romance going on here.
I'd rather he stay out of it, but he could help you.
If Robin can't save those people, the fallout will be every bit as dangerous as Scarecrow's bomb.
So a little backstory here, as we use the Batmobile remote to get us past this toxic gas, Robin is apparently working on a side mission of utmost importance. Maybe we'll find out what that is later in this episode, the episode titled The Joker.
That's three dead now. These animals are going to pay.
We'll stop them. We always do, right?
So there's just one worker remaining, and his tracker shows that he is 80 meters straight down. Looks like this elevator shaft is a dead end.
If I'm going to reach the worker, I'll need a way to get inside this elevator.
I have a feeling the Batmobile will be able to help with that too. So this particular puzzle is one of my favorites in the whole game, perfectly showcasing Batman's ability to use his arsenal of toys and gadgets to solve a particular problem. Here we're using the Batmobile's power winch, which we unlocked in the previous episode, to latch onto the counterweight of this elevator. And as we put the Batmobile in reverse, you can see at the bottom of your screen as the elevator car slowly rises up to ground level, allowing us to sneak in there. Fans of Arkham music might recognize this song as having appeared in both of the previous two games in the series. and played after you found the Batcave in Arkham Asylum, and then when you meet Robin in Arkham City. And once we're inside, it's just a simple matter of using the Batmobile's remote to ever so gingerly lower the elevator back down, and now we can go search for the last worker.
Hey, you! On your feet!
Okay, there he is. He's alive, but he is captive. Alright, so we can't do a takedown through that window. That's what I was trying to do. I guess we're gonna have to find another way around. How about grappling up into the vents? And how about some more backstory as we sneak around?
So here's what I don't get. This night guy shows up out of nowhere and assembles an army this size. It must be Richard Bruce Wayne. I never heard of him. He's a giant orc. Everything he's selling around is chipping into this one. He's all part of Scarecrow's plan.
Yeah, the night took him for every penny they had.
How'd he convince them?
Beats me, but he was convincing enough to get a $3 billion army.
Starting things off with another fear multi takedown, which gets three guys out of the way right off the bat. There's a medic, but I can't reach him now. Whoa, did that guy just vanish? And now we've got ninjas to deal with. Now I finally built up a high enough combo to use an instant takedown on the medic, but that guy's got a sword, which makes him a priority as well. But hey, he's got a sword, I've got a box I can pick up and toss it. That's an improvised throwing weapon, it deals 1d4 damage. So we've seen these ninja guys dodge our attacks before, but if you follow it up with a leg sweep, there's nothing you can do about that. And wow, he just vaulted off the wall, Prince of Persia style. But no matter, brute force bat combat tactics win the day again. And now to check on that last worker.
It's okay. You're safe.
You're too late. We're both already dead. You know about the bomb he's building, right?
Where is he?
I heard him saying he was in the central mixing chamber. You know what that means.
He's getting ready to release his toxin.
I've seen what that stuff does to people. If that gas gets out there, it's gonna be chaos.
I won't let that happen. I'm getting you out of here. Get to the elevator. Jim, I've rescued the second worker. I'm coming to you.
What about Scarecrow?
He's in the central mixing chamber. As soon as the technicians are safe, I'm going after him.
Is it as bad as it sounds?
Worse, Jim. But I'll stop him. You have my word.
God, we're stuck down here. This elevator is the only way out and it's busted.
Don't worry, Batman doesn't do busted.
How are you doing that? Who cares? I'm just happy to be getting out of here.
Yes, happy to be getting out of there indeed. Thanks to Bat intuition in the face of temporary setbacks, using the Batmobile power winch, which thankfully was still attached. Boy, it would not be a good thing if I accidentally hit R1 to detach this winch. I'm not even sure the game would let you do that. Climbing back out and courteously helping our friend. Oh, jeez, what is this now? Is that the Arkham Knight's helicopter charging in? Oh boy, those two workers in the back seat are in for a serious case of whiplash, because I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to fight my way out of here and, yep, sure enough, tanks everywhere.
Alfred.
I saw, sir. Initial scans indicate that the craft is unmanned and being controlled remotely.
Weapons lock deactivated.
Come on then, hero! Let's see if you can keep up with me! You feel that one?
Just like this is the first of many Batmobile battle mode boss fights that we'll have to slog through before this night is over. So since these battle mode fights can get a little tedious and repetitive, I'm going to do a lot of internal trimming here, just to show you the good parts.
Oh, what's wrong? Reaction slowing down! Maybe you should just kill him! Nice shooting! Wish I could be in there, but then, you know, just move back!
He's heat-seeking missiles out of the sky.
So, you still not lost your touch? Good. It's going to make this so much more interesting.
No offense, buddy, but you know what's not interesting? These interminable Batmobile tank fights that are the same every time. Can't we just get back to being Batman, for gosh sakes?
Tonight, you pay for everything!
Oracle, Scarecrow is preparing the bomb in the central mixing chamber. I need a way in, and I need it now.
I'm working on it, but I'm gonna need a couple minutes.
Find it, Barbara.
Classic bat symbol on the hubcaps.
These two were lucky. Scarecrow's forces have murdered the other workers.
Bastards.
Take them back to GCPD, but be careful, Jim. There's militia all over Gotham. I'm going to show Crane what happens when he messes with my city. Oracle, I need that route to Scarecrow. We're running out of time.
You're not gonna like this. There's only one entrance, and it's been sealed from the inside.
What about the service tunnel?
It runs behind the main wall of the facility. I've sent you the location. What are you going to do?
Improvise.
And by improvise, I'm sure Batman means shooting the hell out of that wall with the Batmobile's 60mm cannon. And as we improvise, I'd like to say a word about this music track. It's a motif that shows up in no fewer than three key moments of Arkham Asylum. There's something about it that just sounds like it has the Batman musical vibe. It's exciting, it does a great job of driving the action, it's in 5/4 time, and yet for some reason it was left off the official soundtrack.
Is the strike team ready?
I'm with them now!
The asset is a crucial element of my plan. Do not disappoint me.
Oh, I never disappoint.
What do you think they're planning?
First, we need to focus on stopping Scarecrow. Then I'll deal with the knife.
It's a good thing that someone on the internet was able to isolate the raw audio files from the game. Otherwise, the last 6 years of my life would be a lot less musically interesting. And now all that's left to do is use this extremely convenient ramp-shaped piece of metal to jump into the hole I just created and look for Scarecrow deep within Ace Chemicals. I have to say that a lot of this stuff is so conveniently placed that a more paranoid person might suspect that they're walking right into a trap. Yeah, so that's Scarecrow.
Gentlemen, tonight is the night that Gotham changes forever.
Okay, so there's eight armed henchmen, which makes this a pretty serious predator challenge.
The forsaken symbol of Batman's failure.
First thing I'm doing is taking out these sentry guns, just for kicks.
You're about to turn Gotham into the epicenter of a blast that will transform the entire eastern coast of America into my domain.
I need to stop the chemicals being loaded into the mixing chamber. Once I clear the room, I can focus on stopping the explosion.
Again, starting things out with a fear takedown helps thin the ranks. These particular henchmen seem a little preoccupied with loading the chemicals into the tubes, so they might be a little bit easier to sneak up on than some of the other varieties. Time to get up high and scope out the situation.
Blast radius is at 23 miles and rising.
You're too late, Batman.
No thanks, I think I'd rather rain down death from above. Thank you very much. Well, not death. Just unconsciousness. Okay, getting into the floor grates because it's safer that way. I'm following this guy who's running downstairs to pick up another canister of chemicals, but looks like that area is covered with a sentry gun, so there's nothing to do but wait it out. What I should have done is coat that weak wall on the right with explosive gel, and then blown it up right as that next guy walked past. But using the floor grates is just as effective, if not quite as cinematic.
Complete that task, and pray that you will not experience my fear toxin firsthand.
Okay, so we can glide kick this guy through the window. That's cinematic. Okay, this guy's climbing up the ladder, but if I knock him off the ledge... Yep, that fall takes him out just fine. And this one last guy thinks he can run. Quick batarang. There's a more traditional ground takedown, and the threat is eliminated.
It appears that the flow of chemicals has stopped, which can only mean that you are here, Batman. I've been looking forward to seeing you again.
Again, this is music from the animated series.
Do you really think you've won? Fear makes you predictable. I am in complete control.
Do you feel in control?
How do I shut it down?
Let me go, or she dies.
What are you talking about?
Barbara Gordon.
Oh, jeez, this could be bad.
Have you found him?
Get out of there! Now!
Relax. No one knows I'm here.
Oh, man. How did he even know about Barbara?
Nothing hurts like losing one of the family. knowing that there is no one to blame but yourself.
Alfred.
I heard what that maniac said to you, sir. I've been trying to contact Miss Gordon, unfortunately with no success.
Keep trying.
Preparing neutralizing agent.
What are you doing? It's too late. You can't stop it.
I know. I'm not trying to stop it, but I can reduce the blast radius.
And what will happen to you?
That doesn't matter. Find her, Alfred.
Neutralizing agent deployed.
So, completing this particular part of the game requires you to move as slowly as possible. So, I'm going to do a lot of internal
cutting. These canisters are highly volatile. I'm going to have to move slowly. Be very careful.
Sir, I urge you to reconsider. Evacuate now. If you're caught in that blast, you will die.
There's no other way, Alfred.
There's always a way, sir. Please.
Where is she, Alfred?
I have no idea.
It's my fault they took her.
She was aware of the risks, Master Bruce. She'll be as angry as you are that she's allowed this to happen.
Okay, so we've got the first two loaded.
Neutralizing agent deployed. Blast radius reduced by 25%.
All right, reduce the blast radius.
Sir, listen to me. Don't you see? This is what he wants. Without you, Gotham will be at his mercy. You cannot let him win. I'm monitoring that facility. You're out of time. I'm begging you, leave now.
It's what you taught me. Do the right thing. That's all that matters.
Master Bruce, I implore you. You must get out of there. If this is about Miss Gordon, you cannot blame yourself for what's happened. Save yourself before it's too late.
Goodbye, Alfred.
I wonder if this is how Batman dies. Selflessly sacrificing himself to save his city.
Neutralizing agent deployed.
Increased by 1,000%? That doesn't sound right. Oh, I wonder if we've been affected by the fear toxin that's been filling this room. Oh!
Miss me?
Wow, that was the Joker, but we saw him get cremated. And now we're seeing it happen again.
I've got you.
Just for the record, this is not how things unfold in the regular game. I'm actually modeling this after a sequence in Arkham Asylum where an encounter with fear toxin causes the game to fake glitch and bring you back to the opening sequence, but with a few subtle changes. So that same thing is happening here. Watch closely to see if you can spot the differences.
I've got you under my skin.
Gotcha.
This is how it happened. This is how the Joker died.
Whew. So yeah, that's the opening sequence from New Story Plus, which you only gain access to after completing the game once. Now, this appears to be a flashback where you're going to be put in control of Commissioner Gordon as he's dropped off at the helipad on the roof of Panessa Studios. You can see here that Wayne Regeneration Projects has taken over this facility, which means there's a high likelihood that this is now a secret Batcave outpost. As we're walking up to the VIP elevator here.
Great. How the hell am I supposed to get in?
Voice pattern analyzed. Identification confirmed. Welcome, Commissioner Gordon.
Unbelievable.
Yep, that's the voice of the Batcomputer. We met her in Episode 1 when she introduced us to the Batmobile's battle mode capabilities. Now, as we head down in this rickety elevator, we're going to see a couple of little Easter eggs, including a visual homage to Batman the Animated Series. This movie, The Prosecutor, has the names of a lot of Arkham Knight staff members on the poster. The Terror was playing during the final boss fight of Arkham City. But here's the Ghost in Grey, a reference to the animated series episode Beware the Grey Ghost, where the aging star of young Bruce Wayne's favorite TV show, voiced by who else? Adam West, has to help Batman catch a villain who's planning crimes based on old episodes. That was a fitting Easter egg to appear backstage in a movie studio.
What the hell is this place?
Yeah, good question. It looks like it's a series of prison cells. Let's go check these guys out.
Commissioner, thank God. You have to get me out of here. They've locked me up, running tests
used like I'm some kind of guinea pig. There's nothing wrong with me.
So that's Henry Adams from the missing poster in the diner in the opening sequence. I guess now we know where he is, but the question is why?
Miss me already, Bats? Oh, it's you, Commissioner Boredom. What have you done with my soulmate? If you try to come between us, I'll carve you a smile so wide your head falls off.
So that's Christina Bell, CEO of Queen Industries.
Oh, don't tell me. Don't tell me. You are the police commissioner. Your face was on that billboard they replaced with mine. What are you waiting for, old timer? Johnny C doesn't do requests.
And that's popular performer Johnny Charisma.
What do you want, pig? Coming in here eyeballing me. You think you can police me? Nobody polices the Goliath.
And that's boxer Albert King, the Gotham Goliath. Whoa!
Batman.
I'm glad you came, Jim. You need to see this.
What is this place? Who are these people?
Before it killed him, Joker sent his infected blood out to all the hospitals in the state.
I know, we tracked it all down.
We missed some.
How?
Hospital errors. Transfusions that went unrecorded. 5 people were affected. Untreated, the blood's gestated too long. It's altering them. They're becoming...
Joker. My God.
It's a form of Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, but mutated beyond anything on medical record.
What about that one? He doesn't look like the others.
Henry Adams. He's been infected the longest, but he's symptomless. Immune to Joker's blood. I've got Robin running tests to find out why.
So this must be the side mission that Robin's been working on.
Henry's the key to all this.
I've cooperated. I've done everything you asked. You said it would only take a few days.
You can't hold him here against his will.
We're close, Jim. We can't let him go until we save the others.
Wait. You said 5. I only count 4. There's one missing.
He'll be here soon.
So in case you couldn't tell by that subtle imagery, the last Joker patient is Batman himself.
Bruce.
So I guess this Joker is a hallucination.
Can you hear me, Bruce?
This is the incomparable Mark Hamill reprising his role as the Joker.
Oh, don't act all surprised, Bats. You knew this was going to happen sooner or later. He's stuck deep inside you. Together, we're going to give the city what it deserves. A new Batman. A better Batman. A darker one. Well, we can come back to this later. Sure, you've saved the city by reducing the blast, but Ace Chemicals is still about to explode. You need to start looking out for yourself. After all, you're brooding for 2 now. Oh, Bats, I've missed you. All the subtlety and nuance of a neighbor.
So, as we frantically try to escape Ace Chemicals before it explodes, well, bouncing into every imaginable wall in the process. Here's some more backstory. Towards the beginning of Arkham City, the Joker managed to get some of his infected blood into Batman in order to ensure our hero's cooperation in finding a cure. Now, Batman did find a cure, and it saved his life, but it looks like there were some unforeseen consequences. And as we heroically make the jump to safety, we can now only speculate on what new evil will rise from the ashes of Ace Chemicals. Find out next time on Batman Arkham Knight.